In the last tutorial, we have learned about the tokens, and some types are like keywords, then identifiers, then literals. Okay, so in the last tutorial, we have learned about the keyword and the identifiers. So in this tutorial, we will learn about the literals. Okay, so what do you mean by literals? So as you all know, literals in Python can be defined as numbers, text, or other data that represent values to be stored in variables. So the things which are stored in a variable is known as a literal. Okay, so like you can store values a is equal to like 2, or you can say a is equal to, then you can in the double quotes you can write a string, means text. Okay, so these things are known as the literals, means anything, any value that you can store. Okay, so the first type of literal is string literal. So what do you mean by string literal? So here, like name is equal to, I have written Johnny. Okay, so this is single line string. So this that you have stored is a single line string, as you can see the string which is there, means this Johnny is stored in the variable name. Okay, so name variable, the name of the variable is name, and here as you can see here, address is equal to double quotes, then I have written Jorhat, then I have used this backslash. So using this backslash, you can, it means that the string is continued in the second line also. Okay, so this is for multiple line string. So if you want to continue the string in the next line also, then you have to use this backslash. Okay, so this is for the multiple line string storing in variable name. Then next is this multiple line string stored in variable name address. Then next, numeric literals. What are the different types of numeric literals? So the first one is integer. So integer, as you all know, which don't have the decimal numbers. So here, as you can see, age is equal to 22, or you can write it here as a is equal to 22. This is known as the integer. Then next is float. So float means the numbers which have decimal point numbers. Okay, so you can also store, like if you declare like a is equal to 6. Okay, so you can also write it as 6.0, then it will be a floating point number. Okay, then next one is a complex numbers. So numbers of the form a plus bj, where j is equal to -1. So this is one of the form you will get to know in class 11. What is this? Okay, complex number. So in a complex number, this a is a integer, then this b j, so with b, this j is there, where j represents -1, root over -1. Okay, so this type of numbers is known as a complex number. The next, string literal none. So what is the use of this none literal? So if you want to declare a variable but you don't want to declare any value, then you can use this none. So a none literal is used to indicate absence of value, means you are declaring a variable but you are not giving any value. Okay, then last one is a boolean literal. So boolean literal means those literals whose value is either true or false. So this type of values is known as boolean. So now here, as you can see, this T should be capital in Python and this F should be capital in Python. Okay, so these things you have to remember. Okay, so what are the different types of literals? This string literal, first one, then next is numeric literal, then next is special literal none, then last one is boolean literal. So that much for this tutorial. Thank you.